Now, guys, that's usually the place that I end my show. But tonight I wanted to do a little something special for the people of Juliet and the world.
Yes, I did.
I mean, seriously, as you can always tell, I love doing the roast. I think it's my calling. But the only problem is with a roast, the people pick who we're going to roast on television, and I don't always agree. I have a list of an assload of people who really deserve to be roasted. So tonight, I present to you Lisa Lampanelli's first annual roast of worthless Americans. Thank you. Let's start with everybody's favorite, the cast of The Jersey Shore. The cast of The Jersey Shore is the worst thing to happen to The Jersey Shore since erosion and medical waste. And these a-holes didn't even stay in New Jersey, they went to Miami. Yeah, that's exactly what Miami needs. Since the oil spill, there weren't enough grease balls washing up on the beach. Ugh. Paulie D is so greasy, a Gulf pelican tried to fuck him. Paulie D isn't even the worst. First, there's Snooki. Snooki, holy crap. Snooki is so short and orange, she works part-time as a highway traffic cone. Then there's the situation. The situation, really? Hey, Sitch, guess what? When your nickname's the situation is you're a freaking idiot. This guy made it onto Dancing with the Stars and also has a rap CD out. Can you imagine buying that piece of crap CD? I'd be less embarrassed buying child porn and vaginal itch cream. Who raised these kids? The Real Housewives of New Jersey? Don't get me started on them housewives. The Real Housewives of New Jersey are such a disaster, they're thinking about building a mosque near them. Like the most greatest joke maybe that was ever written, I feel. And by the way, people, those are not real housewives. I know real housewives. Real housewives from Jersey, their only problem is making sure their mustache is waxed before the next PTA meeting. And could these biatches stop pimping their products on the show? Some of them even have the nerve to call themselves a brand. Yeah, you're a brand, you're Pampers, because you're self-absorbed and full of shit. Ugh. The worst one is that crazy hooer Danielle. She even has a sex tape out. Ugh. If I want to see a mangy cougar having sex, I watch the Discovery Channel. Her tape is called Danielle Staub Raw. It's called Raw because when you look up there, it looks like two uncooked pork chops. The last time I saw meat hanging that low, Rocky Balboa was punching it in a freezer. Danielle doesn't have a gynecologist, she has a butcher. When a guy goes south on her, she offers him a side of coleslaw and a baked potato. Danielle Staub, what a mess. Well, at least we know what Lindsay Lohan will look like in 10 years. Lindsay Lohan, is she a terrible driver or what? Lindsay Lohan is to driving what James Dean was to driving. Oh, come on, Ted Kennedy was better behind the wheel. Speaking of someone's driving being off, what about this Tiger Woods? Tiger Woods is not a very bright man. He banged a reality hoe, a porn star, and an IHOP waitress, and it cost him $100 million. Tiger may be part Asian, but he totally sucks at math. Wife Elin, she's no better. She said she has no idea he was cheating. That bitch has got to be more clueless than Jessica Simpson at a spelling bee. Jessica Simpson, that chubby whore. Her weight goes up and down more than a co-ed's head at a fraternity party. No wonder Tony Romo dated her. She's shaped like a football. Her body is more out of shape than Kate Gosselin's snatch. Oh, come on. Kate Gosselin is so stretched out. She's got the only birth canal that offers group boat rides. Come on. It's never good when your uterus has had more kids in it than the noontime showing of Toy Story 3. And talk about exploiting your kids for your own fame. Put it this way, Britney Spears calls her a bad mom. Britney Spears, mother of the year, huh? Her maternal instincts are more questionable than Lady Gaga's gender. Come on, homos, every time I see Gaga, I'm looking for an Adam's apple. Also in the category of parenting gone wild, what's with this Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie? How many little black kids do they have to adopt? They have taken in so many blacks, their table at supper time must look like a read-through of Raisin in the Sun. Oh, come on, raising all those minority kids has to be tough. You know they don't like them all. Come on, I'm pretty sure they've called the UN a couple of times to inquire about the return policy. At least Brad finally shaved that stupid beard. I haven't seen hair that nappy since I bumped into Susan Boyle at the nude beach. Don't worry, we don't have the picture of that. That'd be horrible. Speaking of loving the blacks, what about them Kardashians? Ooh, I love those broads. Kim and Khloe Kardashian have screwed more black guys than sickle cell anemia. They've had more black guys in them than the Basketball Hall of Fame. And just as a side, black guy, isn't it ironic that two women with the initials KKK are so into blacks? Just an observation. No matter what you say about her, though, Kim Kardashian has the best ass in the business. She does. Her jeans are stretched tighter than Bruce Jenner's face. The Tin Man's face was more expressive. And how about that brain trust Paris Hilton? You know, when I heard Paris Hilton was arrested for the cocaine, I can't say I was surprised. Cocaine is the only drug you can do while looking into a mirror. Thank you. It's a fantastic joke. I recognize that. Lastly, I would like to mention a woman whose last film was such a huge bomb, an Arab tried to carry it on a plane in his shoe. Miss Jennifer Aniston. Poor Jennifer Aniston. Her movies suck out loud. Really, who's reading scripts for her? Stevie Wonder? And her acting? Jennifer Aniston has the emotional range of the volleyball in Castaway and the comedic timing of a syphilis outbreak. In closing, I'd like to thank the people mentioned above for not allowing themselves to be roasted on television. Due to the fact that they take themselves too seriously to take a joke, I got to do it without having to look them in the eye and without having to say hello at the after party. In comedy, we only roast the ones we love, but it's been my pleasure tonight to finally make an exception. Now that's a roast, bitches.